While India lifted the ban on the export of hydroxychloroquine, the world continues to find a cure to coronavirus. On one side, hydroxychloroquine was called the Sanjeevani Booty. On the other hand, US President Donald Trump said a combination of HCQ and azithromycin could be a game changer to fight COVID-19. So what is hydroxychloroquine or HCQ?
Conservative treatment, supportive treatment. We are trying various new drugs or some old drugs to combat it. One of the drugs which has been extensively used and is found to be effective is hydroxychloroquine. The disease may be new, but this drug is an old drug. It is the same class as chloroquine, used to combat malaria. It's a beautiful drug. Not only it combats malaria, but it also helps us as a disease-modifying drug in many disorders, autoimmune disorders like lupus, like rheumatoid arthritis.
What makes hydroxychloroquine so popular is the efficacy to fight viral infection. It works by modifying the underlying disease process rather than simply treating symptoms. It inhibits acidification of endosome of a cell that is essential for the virus to replicate and spread the infection. In addition, it could also inhibit the entry of the SARS-CoV-2 virus in the cell. Recently, according to the ICMR advisory, the drug was found to be effective against coronavirus in laboratory studies. However, HCQ is not yet a proven cure for COVID-19. Experts across the globe highlight the need of larger clinical trials. So far, the ICMR allowed the use of HCQ only by health workers, high-risk individuals, those who have come in contact with COVID-19 positive patients and those suffering from COVID-19, and to be used under strict medical supervision.
Is it a safe drug? Not very safe. Of course, it's a decent drug, but it has got its own toxicity. One of the toxicity which we are very worried about is the cardiac toxicity, the heart problem. So all those patients who have got a heart problem, be very careful, because it can prolong QTC problem, prolongation can occur. It is also not to be given to those patients who have got eye problem, because it does cause visual disturbance. It does cause problem in visions. It can also cause skin problem like porphyria, etc. So if anyone has it, please don't take it.
In April to February 2019 and 20, India exported $36.41 million worth of HCQs as per the data of the Pharmaceutical Export Promotion Council. And looking at its growing demand coming from over 30 countries, India can produce 40 metric tons of HCQ, which is approximately 20 crores 200 mg tablets monthly.